Hello children, welcome to my English class. Today we would learn the poem Arcasurina Tree. The poem Arcasurina Tree is from Dutt's Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan, 1882. It is one of Dutt's most famous poems and it describes a tree near the speaker's home that she associates heavily with memories of her childhood and her siblings that have since died. Let us find poet's personal details. Toru Dutt was born in Calcutta on 4 March 1856 in a Bengali family that had converted to Christianity. Her father was Govind Chandra Dutt and her mother was Kshetra Muni Dutt of the Rambagan Dutt family. The Dutt family was one of the first Calcutta families to be strongly influenced by the British colonial and missionary presence. The poem's opening lines describe the grandeur of the Casuarina in minute detail, standing erect and wearing the scarf of the creeper that clutches it like a huge python. The tree is a source of life filled with birds and bees, though the children who used to play under its branches are long gone. This liveliness that surrounds the tree is further detailed in the second stanza, which tells of a baboon, kokilas and cows in its vicinity. Still in the third stanza, the speaker tells us explicitly that it is not because of its magnificence, dear is the Casuarina to my soul. Rather, it is because of her memories of her departed siblings. At the thought of their deaths and their past memories, even the tree seems to lament. Lament means a complaint, an usher's forth. It means a visitor. An airy speech means a strange speech. In the fourth stanza, the speaker recalls various foreign shores, namely France or Italy, where she heard noise similar to the tree's mournful sighs and recalled the tree and her own loved native clime. As the poem closes, the speaker tells us she yearns to return to the Casuarina tree of her youth, which she hopes will be saved from oblivion's curse, which means the inability to be forgotten. This final moment in the poem is also particularly interesting because it implicates the poet herself and the poem itself. The poet is hesitant about her gift of writing poetry and she feels that her own words are weak, but she appeals to love in her plea for the tree to be protected from time's ravages. This links the poem not only to Dutt's preoccupation with loss, the natural world, and the complexity of family relationships, but also to her interest in the nature of the poetic craft and how much of life's complexities can be accurately captured in a poetic format. So children, the poem therefore underlines the importance of memories in human life. The moral we acquired here is, childhood memories are the most beautiful memory that can't ever be replaced. Thank you.